Juliet again, and I'm really excited that you came back to learn more about kindness with me. I can tell you're ready to make a huge difference just by being a part of our Positiviti Junior team. Magical things can happen when we work together to remind the people around us that they deserve to be treated with compassion. That's a fancy word for kindness. Last time I saw you, we talked about what it meant to be kind using your actions, by helping others and going out of your way to brighten someone else's day, by doing things that are important to them. Shout out yes if you were able to cross off any kind actions from your kindness checklist that you made last time. Wow, fantastic! I'm amazed that your kind actions are already spreading throughout your community. That's wonderful. Did you know there are also other ways for us to display kindness? We go so many places, like your school, your house, sports teams, after-school activities, and other spots in your town, that we need a whole bunch of kindness tools to make sure we can spread kindness in every situation. So we need kind actions and some other things to be our best. That's why today we're diving into something new, how to be kind on the playground. Ooh, that's a tough one. You might not have even known that there is a way to be kind on the playground. It's easy to forget that the way we treat people matters when we're just trying to have fun. But actually, everyone is able to enjoy themselves more when they feel respected and accepted by the people around them. So since the playground is for everyone, it's important we do our best to make sure everyone feels welcome there. Making sure everyone is being treated kindly during recess sounds kind of hard to do. There's so many people, right? Well, here are my favorite tips to keeping your playground a safe space for all of your peers. 1. Include everyone. Games and activities can be really exciting when everyone is allowed to play. Maybe you love to play soccer or foursquare at recess. Or maybe you and your friends just like to use your imagination. What's important is that no matter what game you choose to play, everyone should be allowed to join. Your team is stronger when everyone can be a part of it, just like how this Positiviti Junior team is stronger and better with every single one of you in it. 2, meet someone new. If you see someone sitting on a bench or walking around by themselves, don't be afraid to invite them to join in whatever game you might be playing that day. You never know. They could have been feeling down and left out, and your invitation might just make their day a little better. It's important to make new friends, even if you have a lot of them already. The amazing part about kindness is that by reaching out to other people and taking the time to get to know them, include them, and support them, we can call a long list of people our friends. 3, be gentle with your words and actions. It's easy for things to get competitive when you're playing an intense round of freeze tag or racing across the monkey bars. But it's also important to remember that your words and actions still matter, even when things are heating up. Being kind means that even if you really want to win, you continue to use encouraging words, respect the space of others, and are careful to avoid hurting anyone. Your thoughtfulness in how you treat the people you're playing with matters. Injuries and arguments during recess aren't a cool way to relax. So using those uplifting words like, "Hey team, everyone is doing awesome. Congratulations on that win. You did a fantastic job. I'm glad you succeeded. I'm so proud of our hard work. Nice teamwork, everyone." Go a long way to improving the playground for you and your new friends. And they work really well when someone feels upset or irritated. Using a caring word is like the world's best band-aid. Let's think about this. Imagine your friends, Jeremy and Alice, get in a disagreement about the rules of a game that they made up. Alice is upset Jeremy won't follow the rules of the game because he thinks they're unfair. As you watch, you notice they start to say some hurtful things to each other, and Jeremy even begins to cry. If you were on that playground, how would you use kindness to help Alice and Jeremy feel better? are beautiful ideas, team. I really appreciate that you came up with different ways for Jeremy and Alice to get along. If I were on that playground, I might have Jeremy and Alice come up with some new rules that they both think are fair, and maybe remind them that they're both super incredible people who bring something special to that game. I'm glad we were able to work through that together. Okay, team, let's take a deep breath. You learned so much about how to make the playground a safer space for everyone today. Are you ready to step it up? Today, I want you to draw your favorite gamer activity to play on the playground on a sheet of paper. It could be hide and seek, sharks and minnows, pretending you're a princess, or lost on an undiscovered island, or anything else that you love to do. Here's mine. I like to discover dinosaur bones when I'm at recess. Gee, that looks a little lonely. I'm all by myself out there. Oh, I have an idea. Once you finish drawing, pass your paper to the person next to you and have your teammates draw themselves. Stick figures are okay. Playing with you. And then have them pass that paper on again until your whole team is in the picture. Let's include everyone in your favorite recess game, just like we talked about. I'm gonna also invite my friends to join me on the playground today, but I might need to let them know what we're up to. All right, guys, do you wanna come and join us? Wow, that's better. Now we can all play together my favorite game at recess, and no one's gonna feel left out. It's your turn to pass on the kindness. I know you have it in you. Peace out, Positiviti Junior.